In this video, I'm going to be showing you the brand new Revit 2025 Sheet Collection tool, which is going to allow you to organize and group your sheets, and it also unlocks the possibility to have multiple sheets with the same sheet number. Let's go. Now, quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. As you can see, I'm going to be using the sample project from Revit. This is available if you have Revit 2024 and 25, as far as I know. And now let's go here to the project browser so I can show you how to create these sheet collections. So when you go down to sheets, what you'll notice is if you right click, now in Revit 2025, we have this new sheet collection option. This wasn't available before. And when you click, it's just going to create this collection here. So collection one, and then you can just right click here again and then create another sheet collection and so on. Now, for all of these collections, you can right click them, you can delete them, you can create a new sheet within this collection, and then also you can rename it, which is something that I'm going to do now. So let's call this one ceiling plans. And then for the other one, I'm just going to right click and rename this one floor plans, and then just hit enter. Okay, so once we've created these sheet collections, the next step is going to be to, well, load them up with sheets. So here I can select this floor plan, then hold the shift key and select this roof plan, and let's just transfer all of these into the floor plans. So just click on the first one, drag them over floor plans, sheet collection, and now they're here. So if I collapse this, as you can see, they're going to disappear below the floor plans sheet collection. Then let's find the ceiling plans. So I can select this one, hold the shift key, select this one, and then let's move that up. So if you just go up like this, it's going to move up and down your project browser. And now I can place these in the ceiling plans. And as you can see, it's going to expand that. And here we have all of the sheets which we have placed in the ceiling plans sheet collection. Now, one really important thing that is available now once we have sheet collections is that we can have multiple sheets with the same sheet number. So this wasn't available before. So if I select this sheet here, right click, and then go to duplicate sheet with views, as you can see, it's going to give me multiple options. So let's go duplicate with detailing, and it's going to duplicate this sheet. However, for this sheet, I cannot change the sheet number to be the same, which is A100. As you can see, this one is already in use. However, if I select this sheet and then if I move it to the sheet collection ceiling plans, place it here, and now if I change this number, as you can see, once I hit apply, this change has been applied. So I do have the ability to now have the same sheet number for multiple sheets as long as they are in different sheet collections. Now I'm just going to close this down and then I'm going to delete this duplicated sheet. Now, if you would like to remove one of these, so if I find this roof plan and let's say I don't want it to be under floor plans, you cannot simply just kind of drag it out. What you need to do is you need to select it and then drag it up, and you can either put it in another sheet collection like this, ceiling plans, or you just place it over sheets and now it's going to drop it out. And as you can see, now it's outside of the floor plans sheet collection. So that's how you can move these around from individual sheet collections or just back to sheets, which is kind of the rest of these, which weren't really placed inside of sheet collections. Now, also something to mention is, of course, we can collapse these if we want, we can expand them. We cannot add additional sheet collections inside of existing sheet collections, so you cannot have multiple nodes, it's just one. So that's something to keep in mind. And then for individual sheets, if I just open it up like this, you will find that here under the properties panel, under identity data, we have sheet collection. And then here we have multiple options, as you can see. So I can move this one here just open up the sheet and then move it from ceiling plans into floor plans. And now, as you can see, it moved that here in the sheet collection. I can also go to none, so it's just going to keep it outside of both sheet collections, or I can bring it back to ceiling plans, and now, yeah, it's back there where we've started. Now, you can also do this quite a bit faster if you create a sheet list. So if I go here to views and go to schedules and then create a sheet list, just like this, and then here for the fields, I'm going to choose sheet number, sheet name, and sheet collections, so I can just bring those over, and here we have sheet collection, just like that. Click OK, and now it's going to create that. And then, as you can see, here we have some of these where I've added a sheet collection, so you can see that here, and we can change it here. So if I change this to ceiling plans, as you can see, it's going to change over here. If I bring it back to floor plans, I can do that here, and then I can search for other views. So let's say I want my third floor life safety plan in my floor plans, so I can just place it like that, and it's going to move here. So as you can see, it's there under this sheet collection. And of course, at any point, if you want to remove sheet collections, you need to first remove all of the views. So I would have to select all of these views, so just holding the shift key, bringing them back to sheets, and then finding that floor plans sheet collection, and now I can delete it. But you cannot delete it without removing all of the sheets that are in that sheet collection. So I hope you have learned something new. Please tell me in the comment section below, are you using sheet collections in your day-to-day work in the new Revit 2025? Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.